In the next 20 minutes, I will tell you about team development in Uniphase. My name is Peter Lammersma, and I am a Uniphase software developer. There are a lot of questions about Uniphase. Can we use Uniphase in the cloud environment? Can we do containerization? How do we migrate? Can we use microservices? I understand these questions, but people also ask, can we do team development in Uniphase? Well, yes, of course you can. Uniphase has this repository, and that is a database. And the database is multi-user, so Uniphase is multi-user, multi-developer by design. So why is this question asked? That was the thing that kept me busy the last few weeks. So in the next 20 minutes, I will tell you about team development in Uniphase. And why do we doubt? Because I know we can. But I think the question should be, where is the software? But it's more than just a technology. So what is team development? You can develop a team, or you can develop something with a team. So I try to make a model around this question. And we all know when we create a team, because we want to develop something with that team, we have roles and we have procedures from the business and we have processes that we need to follow. So maybe it is not only a technology issue, it's also an organizational question. Can we do team development with Uniphase? Now, when I started to work with Uniphase, it was in the mid-90s, we had this pretty large project, over 200 developers and testers and DBAs, and it was huge. But we were all sharing the same server. It was in the same building, and we had a computer on our desk, and we would work on that computer. And on the computer, Uniphase was installed. Uniphase development environment, I guess it was Uniphase 6 a long time ago. I work with Uniphase 25 years already, so it's more than half of my life. But we knew where the software was because it was in this repository on this server. Well, I can tell a lot about this model, but I think many of us used to work with that model, or some maybe even work with this model. One monolithic application, we use a waterfall methodology. And well, the lead times before we could deliver were very, very long, years. It didn't matter, okay? It was long, long time ago, and we looked differently to software development. Now, when we add that to our graph, to our overview, we have this co-location. We were all sharing the same building. We would meet our colleagues every day. And team development was not really an issue. It made sense. It was the way Uniphase worked. It was the way how people work and communicate. We see our colleagues, we communicate with our colleagues, and we know what we're doing. But things were changing. The projects were too big. They were split into sub-projects. It was a management issue. We had different servers. The projects had their own development teams, and sure, we would still share the same building, perhaps, but not always, because servers were moving from this building to other buildings. Our applications were split. Slightly, we were moving to a more decentralized software development environment. But from a developer point of view, it didn't change that much, because as a Uniphase developer, we had still this co-located workspace. We had our desktop computer with Uniphase installed on it, and we still had this server with repository on it. So nothing really changed there, but the way the methodologies changed. From waterfall, we slightly went to more agile, extreme programming and Scrum. And the lead times went back from very long to, well, nowadays 2 weeks. The sprint of Scrum is 2 weeks. And applications changed from monolithic to applications glued together, and well, things really changed. It wasn't, we were not only using Uniphase, we were using several platforms to build an application. So adding this to this to this schema. But when servers move to different locations, when servers move to clusters, when servers go to server parks to other side of the world, why can't people work from the other side of the world? So from being more centralized and co-located, we had this shift to decentralized, and slightly we went to remote working. There was a huge change about 10 years ago in the financial crisis. 10 years ago, people were allowed to work from home. We got flex offices, flex spaces. We had flexible teams. We got something from like organization model adhocracy from Mintzberg, the term. We had co-working spaces. Lifetime employment didn't exist anymore. Self-employment, things were really changing. But we were still faking the office. We had VPNs, we worked remote desktop. We were allowed to work from home, but meetings were in the office when everybody was in the office. So, still didn't change that much. But the last couple of years, things are changing. We have more geographical spread of people. We work more and more from home. And well, these days with, you know, COVID, we're all forced to work from home. So we need to use, we have all these tools to communicate with each other. So communicating in a team is not really the issue, but communication, collaboration is more about communication. How do people communicate with each other? And we have the tools, but that's not the point. It's about how do we use the tools. So we need to change the processes and the procedures in order for people to work together in a team. Being visible is not longer enough. But still, things were more or less the same. But the last few years, things were getting faster and faster and faster. We got containers, microservices, and the borders of applications, they were fading. You don't deliver an application anymore, you deploy an application. Software as a service, you're 2 weeks to deliver a fix. Well, it's not enough. 2 weeks to deliver a change in an application. No, it has to be now. So we go to continuous delivery to continuous deployment. Applications are not just Uniphase. Uniphase is a part of application, and we use several, really a lot of other technology to build and create our application. Application development is more assembly these days. But how is that manageable in a team when everything is connected to each other? As you can see in this image on the right side, everything is connected to each other. We don't have one node anymore where developers are connected to. In a distributed environment, because this is a distributed environment, is everything connected and disconnected at the same time. I guess you have something like a colleague as a service. I thought it myself, okay? This is a so-called distributed environment, and things are changing. You know, we're forced to work from home. We can't go back to this co-located thing anymore. Maybe we are sometimes at a certain point co-located, but most times we are working remote. And that is a huge, huge change in how we think and how we work. And we don't have access to this network at the office anytime, but we need to be able to work on our software. Well, how do we do that? I think the major question is, where is the software? The business is asking, I need to deliver today. I need to roll back to the version we had yesterday. But when everything is connected and everybody is disconnected at the same time, the question is, where is the software? When every developer says, well, I have the software, I'm working on it. No, that's not enough. It needs to be somewhere. In a centralized environment, it was easy. It was always on the server. You had the single server where everybody was working on, so the software was there, easy. In a decentralized environment, it was also pretty easy. It is on a server. And from, for instance, a Uniphase developer's perspective, it was on the server where he or she was working. Easy, find the right server and there it is. But in a distributed environment where everything is connected and disconnected, it is everywhere. There is no shared server. It has to be deployed anytime, so it needs to be everywhere. But how do you do that? How can you organize that with Uniphase? So the question is, how do we know where the software is? And how can we work from that perspective when it's anywhere, everywhere? How can we work from that paradigm from a Uniphase perspective? But this is not a Uniphase problem. This is really a very generic challenge that everybody has in these days. Where is the software? Where is the stuff that you're working on? I think you know it from, for instance, a presentation on OneDrive or on Google Drive, or is it on your local machine? What version is where? That is exactly the same problem as we're facing here. And it's not only Uniphase. Uniphase applications contain more than just Uniphase. Uniphase applications can use CSS and HTML. And you have the separation of presentation and business logic. So it's not a Uniphase problem. So the solution is also not per se a Uniphase solution. So we can look wider, broader than just that. So let's assume we have a client in this whole cloud of clients and servers that are glued together. And this client has to work on, that can be, for instance, a Uniphase developer, okay? That's easy to communicate. It is a Uniphase developer. And this Uniphase developer needs to work on a piece of coding, a piece of functionality. So when it's everywhere, you must have a location where you can find it in order to work on it. So you need to have the centralized location, and all you have to do is synchronize your local environment and the central environment. That's what we do for many, many, many years already. So we kind of fake this centralized environment that we always had and copy, synchronize with central and local, and we can work locally. And we used to work with, for instance, a version control system that can act as this centralized location. CVS, for instance, that was a centralized versioning system. But nowadays people use Git. And I will explain more about Git in, I think, two or three slides. This is not a Git lecture. Git is so amazing. So we can speak for weeks about Git already. But I remember once I was working for the Dutch Railway Company, and we worked in this disconnected architecture or way of working with a client and a centralized location, but we used a database for the centralized location. We just had a database to store our version of files. It was no rocket science. And nowadays you can even use Docker for that purpose. So let's assume we have this. There's one thing I need to mention. There is an issue. I think we all know this issue. Uniphase has a database in the repository. So we have on the client, we have a database. But all these systems, they work with files. Git works with files. CVS worked with files. When we worked with it, with this centralized database concept for the Dutch railway, we used files to store in the database. So we need to have this conversion between Uniphase database repository ID and file thinking. Well, there are two solutions possible. One of them we know for many, many, many years, that is the UD6 driver of March Hare. It's a premium plugin. It was built as a version control interface, but it works perfect in a disconnected environment. So that is the top of this slide. You have your Uniphase client, and March Hare doesn't use a database for the repository, but it stores directly in files. And these files can be synchronized with the centralized location. The other solution is available as a community plugin. It's on Git Hub, and it is the Listener plugin. And it is a solution provided by Uniphase, but it is a community plugin, so we can use it as open source. Amazing. And it still uses Uniphase as its design, so it has this database for the local repository. And it uses the $UDE function to create import and export files that can be synchronized with the centralized location. And for a nice thing is, for a developer, it works seamlessly. So you don't see anything of this import and export process. It's done completely automated. So that's amazing. So the question is, where is the software? It's on the centralized location, or is it on the client of the developer? The green arrows indicate in this very simple example where the software might be. Now the developer one is working on this application, so he will say, I have the software. I have this version of the software. Developer 2 is also working on the application. So he will say, I have the version of the software. No, if you want the software, you come to me. No, we need to fix it. We need to get it from the centralized location. So there is a small problem. Where is the software? Not a Uniphase problem. This guy, Linus Torvald, had the same problem in 2005 when he was working on the kernel of Linux. And there were many, many people working on this kernel, and they were all working on different locations, all disconnected from there wasn't a single server where they were communicating to or working on every time of the day. So he needed to fix that problem. And he invented Git. Git means a grumpy old man, and he meant himself, I read somewhere, okay. But it is designed with a few goals, a few things in mind. Speed, it needed to be very, very fast. Data integrity. The idea of Torvald was, I need to have this version control system that is not depending on one node in the network. So he invented a system that every client has a copy of the whole copy of the centralized location. So the centralized location was only to synchronize all these clients and provide all the recent versions, including the history. So every client in a process that uses Git has a complete copy of this centralized repository. So it is ideal for distributed and non-linear workflows, because that's what we're facing today. So let's assume we have this one example, how it works. This is how a colleague of mine and me are working these days. We're using Git, and on our clients we have installed Uniphase, and we use Git to synchronize the work. Push and pull mechanisms are supported by Git to synchronize our local Git repository with a centralized Git repository. So we don't have to be connected to the centralized repository every time, but we need to do a pull every time we want to change something, and we have to push our changes back. So, and Git will take care of the synchronization between the two clients. But this could also be 1,000 clients, it doesn't matter. And we not only use Uniphase, but we also use Azure and .NET, and we have CSS and HTML files and many, many, many more. And it doesn't really matter. This is a quote of Torvald. I think he means that working together is not only about the tools you're using, but it's how you work together. So a very small recap of this 20-minute talk is there is no way back. We can't go back to a centralized location. Everything will be distributed. Everything. Now, where is the software? The software is everywhere, and it's on your machine too, but it's also on a machine of your colleague, everywhere. And this is not a typical Uniphase issue, but we can use all the generic tooling there is available. We can use it in Uniphase. There is no reason not to use it in Uniphase. So Uniphase can do modern team development, distributed development. No problem. Maybe you will need a plugin to work distributed. Well, you have the UD6 driver of March Hare or the listener on GitHub, and participating. More information, look at the website of Uniphase, uniphase.com, or visit our website, univideos.com, that's my company. There you will find all the information about this subject and many, many more. Thank you.